Before we get started creating an animatic today, I promised I would make storyboards for my project using some of the tools we explored last episode, and to my surprise, I did! Now, I could have used Previous Pro or Shot Pro to do those storyboards, but I think those apps would be more useful if I had a normal studio setup with actors moving around and 3 or 4 cameras. But this project is a bit odd, more conceptual and metaphorical and with spaces that don't really exist. So it was easier for me to use Procreate to draw what was in my head rather than find objects to represent these things in Previous Pro or Shot Pro. I found that drawing certain things, like hands, was just hard for me. So in those cases, I took a quick photo and then drew over it. There's a few images like this one that I know I want the layers to move against one another. So I'm going to collapse the layers I have in Procreate into 3 or 4 layers, which will be my moving parts. And then I'll export them separately and send them to LumaFusion. Before you ask, I did try AI, and at the end of this episode, you can see what I got with a little rant about how I feel about it. For the detailed storyboard, I decided to use a format I'm very familiar with, which has a column on the left for audio and a column on the right for video, graphics, and notes, which is where I put my storyboard panels. I like this format because over the years, I've learned that if I use 12-point Arial, I can easily tell how long a script is going to be. For example, this is the script for the video you're watching now. It's not a hard science, but it turns out to be about 1 minute per page. And now, it's time to do the fine-tuning on my story. The planning, the crafting, the rearranging, the timing. I need an animatic. An animatic is where the rubber meets the road. It's where the storytelling theory meets storytelling reality. It's where finally, I can begin. Editing. Oh, editing, I love you so much. You've always been there for me when I need to erase something that happened or
Terri.
Add something that didn't happen.
Hey, Terri.
I don't know what I would do without you.
Terri.
Oh, yes?
Are you almost done with the studio?
No, I think I'm going to be in here for quite a while. What were we talking about again? Right, animatics. Animatics are used a lot by advertising agencies and other people who need to hire a crew. They're a great way to find out if your concept is going to work before you spend money hiring people. So to make an animatic, you take your storyboards and put them together with rough audio and some rough animations. The first thing I'm going to do is record a draft of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star for us to edit to. Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how I wonder. In another episode, I'm going to make that sound cool, trust me. I mean, I have no experience with music. I'm not sure it's going to work. Frankly. Now I can quickly cut out the dead space between the lines, drag our storyboard panels to the timeline, and align them with the appropriate text. Now you'll see that the audio clips are linked to the storyboard panels. And this is great because we can now trim the panels and at the same time adjust the timing between the voiceover clips. If you want to move clips around without moving the audio, you can tap this unlink button in the header, which will unlink the whole track. Now, remember those layers I exported from Procreate? We're going to bring these in, and I'm going to build this section with you. I'm going to start with the background clip, which is this one. And above that, I'm going to layer the other objects in the order that I would see them on the screen. So we've got the cup, the hand, the octopus, and 2 layers of water. I'm going to move those against each other. So now we're just going to go into the layers and put simple moves on them. This isn't the final video, so we don't have to get too worried about it. At the first frame, I'm gonna want it up here, off screen. Last frame, as it drops, I want it rotating. Okay, let's play that. Yeah, that kind of looks like it's falling into the water. Now I'm gonna go to the hand. First frame, turn on keyframing and set the hand where I want it. And I want the hand sort of already entering the water. And then at the last frame, I want the hand to have moved sort of in here. Okay, and then I want the octopus to move. I think I would like him rotated a little, like he's swooping in. So I'm gonna put him up here. And then on the last frame, I'll have him kind of down on top of the hand. And notice I've painted the insides of each of these objects with white so that I don't see through them to the next layer down. So let's go back to the beginning. This first section, I'm going to find some morphing software and morph those objects. The cup drops into the sink, the hand goes in, and eventually everything's going to go down the drain and into outer space. That's the plan. Okay, it's a bit odd, but I think it's pretty cool. So I think in the next episode, I'll tackle making some music. Hey, what do you think? Is it time for some music? See you next time. Show off. I had so much fun drawing these objects and then layering them in LumaFusion and putting a little motion on them. This was just pure creativity, just for the fun of it, and I loved it. It's such a departure from what I get to do on a normal day of work, and it was so fulfilling. It really, really was. Now, here's what I got from AI. How do I feel about it? I really feel ambiguous about them. They're almost literally what I typed. Except I didn't ask for a broken hand, and I must have exceeded the quota of things you can ask for by asking for an octopus. Say you get a tabletop puzzle, and you open the box and put the pieces on the table, and then you type, put a picture together, and all of a sudden your puzzle is created. That would be the worst puzzle on earth. You see, the project is for me to create. It's not for AI to create. I thought the whole idea was to give robots the worst jobs on earth, not the ones everybody wants, the creative jobs. I got so much enjoyment from doing this part of the project. I love the drawing, I love the editing, I love putting the layers together. I don't want AI to do that for me. But look, we can ignore all that. AI can do what it wants, because being creative is something you do for yourself.